I would say Team will bring AI to the iPhone, but not in a way that you're expecting. More onto that later, AI will change everything. So let's break down the features, the release dates, and at the end, I'll also tell you if your iPhone will be compatible with iOS 18. Now, obviously, take everything with a grain of salt. These are just reports, these are just rumors, but I'm personally super excited about iOS 18. I'm sure you are too, so let's just have fun and see what we could expect with iOS 18, which, by the way, I have been invited to the Apple event this WWDC, so I'll be there. I'll be the first one to share all the latest news within iOS 18 to all of you. So if you're new to the channel, if I were you, I'd hit subscribe. Starting off with features. According to reports, there will be a massive revamp to the home screen, allowing users to control how the apps are actually placed in the home screen. On Android, you can place an app wherever you want in the home screen, right? And in iOS, if I want to place this app right here, it just moves up top, right? Well, in iOS 18, that could potentially change, allowing the customization that we can do to our iPhone so much bigger, right? So we can actually place wallpapers and actually arrange the apps according to the wallpaper. It should be very fun. Something else that's very fun are custom AI emoji. iOS 18 would allow us to actually type in a prompt to an emoji. So you could basically ask, give me an emoji of Leo Messi, or give me an emoji of somebody swimming or running in the middle of the mountains. You could add a prompt, and the customization for this would be awesome. Just imagine for dog greets, just imagine, make me an emoji of a Jack Russell. Make me an emoji of a grandma singing. Possibilities are pretty much endless, and I'm super excited to see what Apple could potentially do with this. Fun fact, there's already an app called Newchi, links in the description, that already does that. So you can actually type in a prompt and it will create an emoji of whatever you want. It works pretty well. I mean, look at this. I actually made an emoji of Tim Cook, and you can actually add it as a sticker. It's not an emoji, it's a sticker. But still, if you want to play with that feature now, before it's actually logged, link in the description if you want. Siri will act more conversational. Same thing as we have with ChatGPT. Whenever we talk with ChatGPT, it feels like you're actually talking to a human. Obviously, I'm doing this because it's not an actual human, but it feels like you're talking to a human because it's got the pauses. It's actually replying to you. It actually remembers what you're saying. So it's got background info. And Siri, according to reports, will be more like that. Siri will also auto-summarize notifications. So let's say you have Do Not Disturb on, and once you put back Do Not Disturb, you have tons of notifications, Siri will automatically summarize them for you. It's like this, you don't have to keep scrolling and read every single one of them. Apple, every WWDC, implements all of its latest new features into all of their services and apps, and iOS 18 is no exception. Apple Music is reportedly going to have auto-generated playlists. So depending on the mood, the style that you're in that specific moment, maybe it's raining, maybe you're in a mood, or maybe it will connect with the Apple Watch with your heart and will know exactly the song that you want in that exact moment. Who knows? It should be a lot of fun. And also, we're also going to get better transition. With iOS 17, we have the crossfade, but now with iOS 18, we could potentially have better transitions, meaning when a song ends, it could remix into the next song. It's not like a crossfade, it will literally remix the last seconds of the songs with the first seconds of the next song. That I'm very excited about. The Notes app will also be getting improvements. It would have voice memo integration. It would grab that voice memo and would actually transcribe it into text. Really useful for students if you're typing with your iPad, for example, and maybe your teacher speaking too fast and you want a voice memo, and it would write all the notes for you. Safari is also supposedly getting the intelligent search, which would have on-device AI to identify key topics and phrases on web pages to offer a tiny summary. We've previously seen other companies doing this, and it's extremely useful for working and for productivity and for students as well. The calendar app would also have reminders integration, something that Fantastical, which, by the way, my friend, my friend literally uses Fantastical, which is an app that merges reminders with notes and all that stuff. So it's really cool that you would have all that integration with reminders and notes, and it would all work beautifully. Because right now, reminders and notes are two different apps and they don't work together at all. Something for me, for example, I use Notion all the time, and calendars work with reminders, and that's something that I would really want Apple to do. So I'm sure Fabi is happy right now. Fun fact, Apple has already previewed some iOS 18 features publicly, but those are focused on accessibility. But I think they're also super cool to mention. For example, Apple CarPlay will now recognize sounds. So if it hears beeping, it will actually show up in CarPlay. iOS 18 is also bringing eye tracking to the iPad and iPhone. So you can literally interact with your devices with your eye, very similar to Vision Pro. And for accessibility, this changes everything. There's also some improvements with motion sickness, so you actually don't get dizzy using your iPhone in the car, and it actually moves the display just enough so you don't get motion sick. There's music haptics for those who can't hear. You can actually feel and listen in a way, the music. So for those who can't listen, you can actually kind of feel the music the best as you can. Now, as I said in the beginning of the video, AI will not be as we were expecting, because as of now, most people are using AI as a chatbot. Same thing as ChatGPT. So if you want to ask it something, you can literally just get something and it will do it for you. According to reports, Apple is currently talking to Google and OpenAI to bring a lot of AI features to iOS. But a lot of reports are currently saying that we wouldn't have a specific chatbot as we have with ChatGPT. Everything would be more voice oriented and most of the features would act as features, but you wouldn't really see them or feel them most of the time because they just work in the background and works so well, which is a good thing in a way. For example, Siri suggestions, when you pull down on your iPhone or iPad, your iPad will automatically let you know what app you probably want to click on. And it's features like this that we can probably expect to come with iOS 18. Features that work so well that you kind of forget that it's AI, because it kind of just works like magic. So in terms of release dates, WWDC is happening June 10th, so that's when it will actually be announced. The betas will be happening in the summer, and supposedly, according to reports and according to all the previous years, we should have the public release of iOS 18 on September next to the iPhone 16 and iPhone 16 Pro. And in terms of compatibility, is your iPhone going to be compatible with iOS 18? According to reports, iPhone XR and iPhone SE 2nd generation and above will be compatible. That means if you've got an iPhone SE, the first gen, or the iPhone 10, that won't be compatible, which is kind of sad. Seeing the iPhone 10 being discontinued by software updates after what the iPhone 10 gave us, which was such a massive launch, kind of nostalgia. Anyways, if you want to keep watching the interview with John Ternus and Josh, you can watch this video right here, or you know what you could do? You could subscribe, because I'll be there in Cupertino covering the entire launch. So you're going to be the first ones to know about all the latest updates within iOS 18. Subscribe.